DDT. It was cheap, effective, and we loved it.
The real threat to the survival of man is biological, in the shape of hordes of insects.
But one woman challenged the way we looked at chemicals and nature, giving us a new vision of the future. Rachel Carson's Silent Spring, tonight on The American Experience. Major funding for this series is provided by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and by the financial support of viewers like you.
Good evening and welcome to The American Experience. I'm David McCullough. It's happened many times. A book, a single book, has changed American life, changed our history. The book itself became an event in the American experience. There was Uncle Tom's Cabin by Harriet Beecher Stowe, the little woman who started the Civil War, as Lincoln said. In 1906, a book called The Jungle by Upton Sinclair awakened the country to the horrors of the Chicago stockyard, and in less than 6 months, Congress passed the first pure food law. Closer to our own time came Ralph Nader's Unsafe at Any Speed, with its shattering indictment of American automobiles. Tonight's story is about one of the most important of all such books. This one, Silent Spring, and its brave, unlikely author, Rachel Carson. It was not Rachel Carson who discovered the deadly impact of pesticides on the natural world, nor was she the first to write about it. But when she did, it was both as a scientist and as a writer of exceptional power. She began her landmark work in the 1950s, when for a woman to speak with any authority in science was extremely rare. And remember, too, she was on her own, with no university or institutional backing. Yet no universities or institutions, no politicians, not television or the newspapers, sounded the alarm as she did. Rachel Carson changed our lives, changed how we think about the world and our place in it. Rachel Carson's Silent Spring.